This is the adjustment that will decide the fate of the project. This adjustment will determine the fate of this project. How can we make it perfect? There's no room for compromise.
What's wrong? You look so serious.
Hey, Angel. This time, I'm making a crucial adjustment that will determine the accuracy of this machine. I've actually been thinking about this adjustment method since the design stage. Anyway, this is really important.
Oh, I see. But what really matters to me is what kind of funny mistake you'll make this time. So, what are we doing today?
Simply put, I'm determining the exact center line of the A-axis.
What? That's it. I don't get it. We already adjusted the A-axis in the last video and even solved the lubrication issue. Wasn't everything about the A-axis already done?
The last video was about the rotation of the A-axis, but this time, we're determining its exact center line. To understand why this adjustment is so important, you need to know the fundamental aspects of this project.
What? Explain it properly. I know you're a freak, and you're always doing weird things, like making a frame out of carbon fiber and epoxy granite, or setting up LinuxCNC and getting the machine running before it's even finished. Honestly, it just seems like you're making things up as you go.
Angel, to someone like you, the way a genius like me thinks might seem strange. But trust me, everything I do is meticulously planned. I consider every possible scenario, to the point where I sometimes overthink so much that even I don't know what I'm thinking anymore.
Isn't that the same as not thinking at all?
All right, let me explain it in a way you can understand. When building a five-axis machine from scratch, there are a lot of challenges to overcome. Designing the machine and buying motors or other components isn't really an issue. You can design the machine using free CAD software like Fusion 360, and you just buy the parts based on your budget. The real challenge is manufacturing the machine's custom parts and fine-tuning them. Making small parts isn't a problem. You can use a home CNC router, a small benchtop drill press, or handheld power tools to get the job done. But large parts are a different story. To make big metal components like the column or saddle, you'd need an industrial milling machine. And let's be honest, most people don't have one. That's where epoxy granite comes in. It's a well-known alternative to cast iron. Epoxy granite is made by pouring a mixture of epoxy resin, gravel, and sand into a mold and letting it harden. With this method, you don't need a large machining center. All you need to do is make a mold, but that introduces another problem. The surfaces where the linear guides will be mounted need to be finished with extremely high precision. In my workshop, it's impossible to create epoxy granite molds with parallelism and flatness accurate to 0.01 millimeter. That's why I embed pre-machined aluminum plates into the epoxy granite at the critical points. This ensures that the necessary precision is maintained. Now do you see why adjusting the A-axis is so important?
No, I don't get it at all. I feel like you're making fun of me. This makes so little sense that I kind of want to smash this machine, or maybe just reduce it to ashes in the flames of hell.
No, anything but that. I've spent over a year carefully building this. Angel, please, have mercy. Don't reduce my soul to ashes in the flames of hell.
If you don't want to be reduced to ashes, explain it in a way I can understand. I won't tolerate failure ever again.
Understood. Almighty Queen of Hell, Angel, let me explain it once more. First, I built the Z-axis. Since it's made only of aluminum plates and angle stock, and it's relatively small, there were no major issues in making it. Next, I mounted the linear guides for the X-axis and attached them to the base plate of the carriage, adjusting for parallelism and alignment. In other words, I fine-tuned everything at this stage to ensure the required precision once the machine is complete. Then, by casting it in epoxy granite while everything is properly aligned, I can guarantee that the necessary precision is maintained.
I see. Normally, you'd machine the parts with high precision, but you're locking everything in place after fine-tuning it first.
That's right. Basically, I'm planning to use the same method this time as well, but it's even more complex than when we built the saddle. The aluminum frame of the column is split into two parts, and since the A-axis is supported by these left and right aluminum frames, it must be secured firmly after adjustment. To achieve this, I need to control the stepper motors on both sides with LinuxCNC, enabling independent homing for each side.
So, since the left and right aluminium frames are independent right now, if the stepper motors aren't powered, their positions can shift easily. But if they can home independently, they can be restored right away.
Exactly. In this state, we can already consider the left and right aluminum frames as a single unit. Then, by using this shaft to align the A-axis to the X-axis with a parallelism of about 0.01 millimeter and locking it in place with epoxy granite, we can ensure that the required precision is maintained.
So the concept is the same as with the saddle. You finish all the necessary adjustments first, then lock everything in place just as it is.
Exactly. Normally, this wouldn't be considered the correct way to make these kinds of parts. But when you are building a machine without a fully equipped workshop, it's a practical solution.
I see. Now I finally understand why you set up LinuxCNC at this stage. You always seem drunk and totally thoughtless. But I guess you actually do put some thought into your work.
So, you've finally realized that I'm a genius. That was a close call. My machine was nearly reduced to ashes by a demon.
Oh, come on. That was just a joke. Like I would ever actually do that.
I hope so. Anyway, let's get started. I've begun setting up the left and right home switches for the Y-axis. But before that, let me quickly explain some LinuxCNC settings. From my research, in LinuxCNC 2.9, joints are now tied to the machine's kinematics, which means you can't just add more joints freely. On top of that, I wasn't sure how to properly configure two home switches. The solution to this is enabling the gantry feature. By adding this feature, you can split a single joint into two and get homing to work correctly. For more details, check the official LinuxCNC documentation. And if my explanation didn't make much sense, don't worry about it. This is only relevant for people who actually want to set up a gantry system.
Okay. I have no idea what that means, but whatever. If I listen to too much confusing explanation, I'll start wanting to burn the machine down again. So hurry up and move on.
To put it simply, when homing starts, both axes begin moving as they search for the home switches. When one of the home switches is triggered, that axis goes into standby mode and waits until the other home switch is activated.
Before homing, no one knows how much the two frames are misaligned. But with this method, they will always return to the same position after homing.
Exactly. First, we need to check and adjust the parallelism of the X-axis and A-axis in the Y direction. To do that, we'll attach a measuring shaft and check its alignment with the X-axis. Then fine-tune it to ensure perfect parallelism.
The home switch is on the back of the plate, so adjusting it looks tricky.
Yeah. I positioned the home switch in a less visible spot to make the machine look cleaner, but that ended up making the adjustment more difficult. Still, it's not a big deal, because I'm a freak. The trigger for the home switch is secured with two bolts, but one side is slotted, allowing for height adjustment.
I'm glad the shaft goes all the way through to the other side. If it didn't reach the bearing on the opposite end, we wouldn't know what reference point to use for alignment.
What are you talking about? This structure was part of a plan from the design stage of the machine. I knew from the beginning that without a through shaft design for a precision shaft, proper machine alignment wouldn't be possible.
But if a shaft like this is running through, how are we supposed to mount the tilting table?
It seems you've misunderstood. This shaft is only used for alignment purposes. Once the adjustment is done, I will remove it.
I see. So that's what it was. I knew something felt off.
You you can see that the shaft isn't parallel to the x-axis. I can check when the home switch is triggered on the LinuxCNC screen. While watching the screen, I roughly adjust the position of the trigger. For fine adjustments, I use a dial indicator against the trigger to precisely control the amount of adjustment. Adjustment complete. Perfect. I can already hear the cheers of I at my flawless work. Next, I'll adjust the x-axis to make it parallel to the z-direction.
That's a pretty big misalignment. Can you really fix it when it's this far off?
Of course I can. Do you even know who you are talking to? I'm freak. Nothing is impossible for me. It's designed to be adjustable. Watch closely.
Okay, got it.
Well, that's a total fail.
What happened to all that confidence you had a minute ago?
What are you talking about? Did I say something? I'd like to focus on my work, so could you please be quiet? I'll adjust the part. Everything is going exactly as calculated.
Yeah, right. As if that's true.
Thank you. Since I've already removed the alignment shaft, I'll take this opportunity to reduce the outer diameter by about 0.01 millimeter where it fits into the bearing. That's because the shaft was slightly too large, and it was difficult to insert it into the bearing. Perfect. Next, I'll check whether the distance between the left and right aluminum column frames changes when the y-axis moves.
What do you mean? I didn't really get that.
If the linear guides mounted on the aluminum column frames aren't parallel, the distance between them will change when the y-axis moves up and down. Right now, the left and right frames are still separate. But once they are joined together with epoxy granite, any misalignment will put stress on the linear guides. That's why I'm adjusting it now, while I still can.
It's moving more than 0.1 millimeter. That means the y-axis linear guides aren't parallel.
Exactly. If we join the left and right columns together in this state, there's a risk that the resistance will become too high. Perfect. This level of adjustment is more than enough. That's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. It might not look like much progress was made, but this was a really important adjustment.
So, what's next?
Right now, the machine is still in this state. But next, I'll start working on the parts other than the aluminum column frames. In other words, I'll begin building the mold using carbon fiber plates.
Okay, I'm looking forward to it. Making the saddle was fun, especially thanks to your entertaining little failure.
If you are interested in this project, I suggest you subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any videos. If you empathize with my project, why don't you become a member and support this channel? There are a few benefits, but as long as you are a member, your name will appear at the end of the videos as a patron. In other words, you can be a part of this project. So, please look forward to the next video.